One of the biggest challenges with writing secure code is that issues are typically only caught in the CI/CD pipeline. And this leads to a long feedback loop for the developers. Or sometimes the lack of automated unit testing in a legacy code base can make any new change a scary experience. My name is Derick Chen, and I'm a developer specialist solutions architect with Amazon Web Services. I help developers build complex systems better and faster. In the last video, we explored how we can use Amazon Q Developer to speed up our work in an unfamiliar code base. We used Amazon Q Developer to explain functions that we are seeing for the very first time, implementing a feature using the slash dev function and to generate source code inline at a lightning speed. Now, let's see how we can leverage on Q to improve the code quality, catch security issues that we may not be aware of before going for code review. We will ask Q to run a project scan and uncover issues that might lead to serious incidents. It takes a few seconds and we will see all the results in the console. You can also view all the files that are being included in the scan. Let's try to fix one of them together with Q. Let's take a look at this particular issue in the getting campaign rules lambda function. Looks like we're doing a DynamoDB scan naively, and pagination is not being managed. We just need to hover over this line of code and we can see more details on the issue and how to fix it. All right, looks like we just need to add a pagination to the scan. Sounds simple enough. I guess it's time to dig out pages of documentations on the API, or we can just ask Q. Let's ask Q how to implement pagination instead of opening our browser tabs. So we are creating a Boto3 client. We have already done that. And the last evaluated key value would help us with the pagination. Let's insert the generic table scanning code suggested by Q into the IDE and integrate with what we have so far. With just a few indentations and the updating of variable names, we are good to go. Ain't that a walk in the park? Now, about those automated tests, we don't seem to have any unit tests for the serverless backend yet. Let's fix that. I'm sure you have tried creating unit tests with available chat-based GenAI tools, copy and pasting one function at a time. But this time, let's ask Amazon Q Developer to generate a whole suite of tests at one go for an entire module. We will go to Q and use the slash dev feature again. This time, we will ask Q to implement unit tests for the entire retail module. This includes an orchestrated checkout scenario with product reservation, release, and also making payments. In just a few minutes, Q comes back with a suite of unit tests nicely packaged under the test folder. You may still need to install the additional packages that are needed. Then, all that's left to do is to run these tests, rinse and repeat for all the other modules. In this video, we took a deep dive in how to quickly resolve security issues right in our IDE with the help of Amazon Q Developer. And instead of generating unit tests one function at a time, we used the slash dev feature to generate unit tests in bulk. I hope you've learned something new that gives you extra confidence for your next release. Amazon Q Developer is constantly receiving upgrades and learning new superpowers. Check out the additional resources in the description. If you like this video and want more hands-on technical content, be sure to like this video and subscribe to to the AWS Developers YouTube channel.